Morning and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we will understand the characteristics of a reaction for class 10th. What is chemical reaction? When reactants are converted into products. The conversion of reactant into products is accompanied by 5 characteristics which can be noticed easily. We will understand one by one with a suitable example. The first character or feature is evolution of a gas. During some chemical reactions, gas is released as a byproduct, and we can identify the gas, we can observe the gas. Let's see examples. When any metal react with acid, metal salt is formed and hydrogen gas is released. This is the characteristic property of a metal. Also, when metal react with acid, then hydrogen gas is evolved with the pop sound. This is the characteristic property of a hydrogen. Also, hydrogen is released with the pop sound. What are the other properties of hydrogen? It is colorless, third, odorless, no smell. Fourth, does not help in combustion, but it burns itself. It is released with pop sound. Second, colorless. Third, odorless. Fourth, does not help in combustion. And fifth is it burns itself. Easy. So this is a reaction when a gas is released. Let's see other example. Second example is, if we take zinc granules in a flask, these are the zinc granules in a flask, and we added a few drops of sulfuric acid. H2SO4 is a sulfuric acid. Then what will we observe? We will observe zinc reacts with sulfuric acid and hydrogen gas is released and bubbles of hydrogen gas are formed around the zinc granules. These are the bubbles of hydrogen gas formed around zinc granules. Easy? We can see gas is released, bubbles are formed. Another practical examples can be photosynthetic reaction. In our body, respiration takes place. That is also reactions in which gases are released. Let's see both examples, photosynthetic versus respiration. Photosynthesis versus respiration. What will happen in photosynthesis reaction? CO2 plus water in presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, glucose is formed, C6H12O6, by plant cells, and oxygen gas is released in atmosphere. Now animals consume this oxygen during inhalation, and a metabolic reaction takes place in body. C6H12O6 plus oxygen gas. This will break down glucose, CO2 plus water plus energy is released in the body of animals or a human. Easy. CO2, here is a gas. In photosynthesis, oxygen gas is released. So we can say in both reactions, gases are released. These are the examples of evolution of a gas in a chemical reaction. These gases escape into atmosphere. What is other characteristics property of this CO2? This has a unique property to turn lime water milky. When CO2 gas is passed through a solution of calcium hydroxide, then It turns a white calcium carbonate is formed. So it is a unique property of CO2 also. It turns lime water milky. We will understand it in the next lecture also in the type of reactions. Easy. This is the first characteristic property when a gas is released during a chemical reaction. Now second characteristic is formation of a precipitate. Formation of a precipitate. Now we have to understand first what is a precipitate. A precipitate is a solid insoluble mass formed during a chemical reaction which settle at the bottom. Why? Because it is insoluble, so it will settle at the bottom of a container. That solid insoluble mass is called a precipitate, and reactions are called a precipitation reaction. Some reactions are characterized by formation of a precipitate. Easy? And understand it with the example. I taken solution of a lead nitrate and PbNO3 twice is a lead nitrate in a test tube and added potassium iodide KI in it. Then there will be a reaction in both reactants, PbNO3 twice plus KI. What will happen? Double displacement reaction will take place. As a result, potassium nitrate plus lead iodide is formed. Now, this lead iodide is a solid insoluble mass and its color is yellow. Yellow PPT. PPT represents precipitate. Simple. This is the most favorite topic again. Many times questions have been asked from precipitate or precipitation reactions. Easy. Let's see one more example. When barium chloride is dissolved in sulfuric acid. Barium chloride is dissolved in a sulfuric acid, then again double displacement reactions takes place. Double displacement we will study in a next lecture. As a result, barium sulfate is formed and HCl is formed. Now this barium sulfate is again solid insoluble mass and its color is white. Easy, this is the second feature or a characteristic of a reaction when a precipitate is formed during a reaction. Easy. So we have observed two precipitates in previous reaction, lead iodide yellow in color, and in this reaction barium sulfate white in color. Easy. This is the second characteristic. Both these reactions can be used for a third characteristic, that is a change in color. So we are going to understand now third characteristic. Third is a change in color. Both previous reaction can be used again. But let's see one more example. If we take a solution of a purple solution of a potassium permanganate the formula is KMnO4 and color is purple in a test. test tube, and we added a few drops of a citric acid or lemon juice, and if we shake the test tube for a while, then what will we observe? That this purple color solution starts fading, and finally purple color disappears. So what we have observed, when a few drops of citric acid are added in a purple color potassium permanganate solution, then solution starts fading and finally disappear. So we can say there is a change in a color. Is it? This is third characteristic, change in a color. Both previous example can be used because we have observed lead iodide is formed, that is yellow in color, and barium sulfate is formed, that is a white in color. So this is the third characteristic, change in a color. Now let's move to fourth. Fourth is a change in a temperature. Some reactions in which energy is released and some reactions require energy. The reactions in which energy is released, those are called exothermic reactions, and the reaction in which energy is required or observed by reactants are called endothermic reaction. We will discuss again, but now understand it with examples. For example, a piece of sodium is dropped in a container containing cold water. Water is cold here, and this is a sodium piece. What will happen? Sodium reacts with the water to form sodium hydroxide plus energy plus hydrogen plus a large amount of energy. So we can say during the reaction energy is released. So definitely there will be rise in temperature. If you touch the beaker containing water, it will be slightly warm. And what is the other property? This energy released is quite high, and now this hydrogen gas catches fire. This will burn. Is it? And sodium start floating on the container or a beaker. What will happen after the reaction? Sodium starts floating on the surface, and finally jo hai hydrogen gas is released, that will burn, that will catch fire. This is floating sodium. This is the example of a change in a temperature. Is it? Another example can be use sodium instead of sodium, use calcium. Calcium plus water. As a result, again calcium hydroxide plus hydrogen plus energy. But this energy is not that sufficient, so that hydrogen here does not burn again. When reacts with sodium, it burns. But when reacts with calcium, it does not burn. But energy is released, again beaker will become slightly warm if you touch it with your hand. Is it? This is fourth characteristic, change in temperature. Now last is fifth, and that is change in state. Fifth and last characteristic is change in state. This is very easy. During this, there will be no chemical change, only physical state will be changed. Simple example is water. When water is boiled or heated, it will convert into gas. Here physical state is liquid, and here is gas. Another example can be, if you take ice and heat it slightly, it will convert into liquid. So what will be happening here? Just physical states are changing, solid to liquid, liquid to gas, but still no chemical change, because in ice, in water, or in a vapors, formula is the same, H2O. Clear? So these are the five characteristics. I write it again here. First was evolution of a gas, second formation of a precipitate, third change in color, fourth is change in temperature, and fifth last one is change in state. Second one is quite important, very important. Correct. Many time question have been asked by CBSE board. Easy. So these are the five characteristics. In next lecture, we will understand types of reactions. Again, with the definition and with the suitable examples and with the practical examples. Easy. So this is the today topic. Okay, so keep learning with me. Press the bell icon for further notification. Stay safe at home. Follow the lockdown strictly. Thank you. Bye bye.